Recording in progress.
Good morning, students. Good morning, sixth standard. It's your history period. Today we have to revise lesson sources of history and time. Okay. आज हम sources of history और time से related जो भी points है, जो भी question answers है, हम उसकी revision करने वाले हैं. Okay? Now, what do you mean by history? History is a science that tells us about events in the past. History is a science that tells us about events in the past. यानी past में जो घटनाएं घट चुकी रहती है उसके बारे में हमें history से जानकारी मिल सकती है. Okay. The time that has already gone by is the past time. The time that we are now is the present time. And the time that is yet to come is the future. Okay. Now, the science that tries to understand past events is called history. Ancient objects, structures, sculptures, pots, coins, inscriptions, copper plates, books, manuscripts, traditional stories and songs remembered over many generations, etc. are the sources of history. Okay, the sources of history are of three types: material sources, written sources and oral sources. Okay, now the study of science helps us to find the answers to many questions. For example, environmental science studies the problems of degradation of the environment, pollution, etc., and looks for their solutions. In the same way, every science has its own areas of study. History studies events of the past. Okay, now history attempts to find out answers to many questions by studying the way of thinking of past societies, their actions and the consequences. See here once again, history kis baat ki koshish karti hai? History attempts to find out the answers to many questions by studying the way of thinking of past societies. Yani hamare jo ancestor hoke gaye उनकी सोच किस प्रकार की थी, वो क्या सोचते थे, वो और उसके ऊपर वो क्या एक्शन लेते थे, और वो एक्शन यानी किस तरह से वो काम या कार्य करते थे, और उसका नतीजा यानी परिणाम यानी कॉन्सिक्वेंस क्या होता था, इसके बारे में ये सारे आंसर्स हम हिस्ट्री में जाके ढूंढ सकते हैं. ठीक है, द स्टडी ऑफ हिस्ट्री मेक्स इट पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू स्टडी व्हाट इज एंड व्हाट इज नॉट फेवरेबल फॉर द प्रोग्रेस ऑफ ह्यूमन सोसाइटी. हिस्ट्री दस प्रोवाइड्स अस विद गाइडलाइंस अबाउट हाउ वी शुड बिहेव टुडे इन ऑर्डर टू शेप अ गुड फ्यूचर. हमारा फ्यूचर अच्छा हो इसलिए हमें आज क्या करना चाहिए इसके बारे में हमें हिस्ट्री से जानकारी मिल सकती है. ठीक है, we learn about the progress of human civilization. We also understand how people's way of life went on changing. ठीक है, लोगों की लाइफ में किस तरह से चेंजेस आए और क्या क्या घटनाएं ऐसी घटी जिसकी वजह से ये चेंजेस आए उसके बारे में हमें हिस्ट्री से जानकारी मिल सकती है. ह्यूमन सिविलाइजेशन में किस तरह से प्रोग्रेस हुई, जैसे व्हील है, जब व्हील का आविष्कार हुआ है ना, तो जैसे ही व्हील की गति बढ़ती गई वैसे हमारे भी प्रोग्रेस होती गई, हमारे मीन्स ह्यूमन बीइंग की प्रोग्रेस होती गई. इसके बारे में ये सारी बातों के बारे में इसमें जो जो यानी स्टेप बाय स्टेप हमारी प्रोग्रेस कैसी हुई इसके बारे में हमें हिस्ट्री से पता चलता है. ठीक है, एवरी विलेज, सिटी, डिस्ट्रिक्ट, स्टेट एंड कंट्री हैज इट्स ओन हिस्ट्री. Similarly, the earth, its mountains, water bodies, the animal world, mankind all have their own history. Now, see, now I'm going to tell you the examples of material sources, written sources, and oral sources of history. Okay, coins, forts. CoINS coins. ठीक है, forts यानी किले, pots यानी बर्तन, old structures यानी पुराने जो monuments है, temples है, या फिर यानी मकबरे है, all these are old structures. Then pillars, rock cut caves, all these are included in material sources. Once again I repeat, listen carefully. Coins, forts, pots, old structures, pillars, rock cut caves are included in material sources. Okay, now written sources: letters, copper plates, stone inscriptions, biographies are included in written sources. Once again, I repeat: letters, copper plates, stone inscriptions, and biographies are included in written sources. Then traditional songs, folk songs, folk tales, all these are consist of oral sources. All these are consist of oral sources. Okay, now the method of using a number of different tests to determine whether the evidence is reliable is called a scientific method. Keep it in mind. The method of using number of different tests to determine whether the evidence is reliable is called a scientific method. The study of history makes it possible for us to study what is and what is not favorable for the progress of human society. Right now, time is continuous, right? Time is continuous. There are different methods of reckoning time. Reckoning means calculating. Reckoning का meaning क्या होता है? Calculating, ठीक है? Our Earth rotates around its axis. Axis यानी उसकी कक्षा. At certain speed, हमारी जो पृथ्वी है वो घूमती है एक certain speed से, ठीक है, अपनी कक्षा में घूमती है. Similarly, it also revolves around the sun. जो खुद से भोताल फिरती है और उसके साथ साथ वो सूरज के भोताल भी घूमती है. It moved in a circle. It moved in a circle, ठीक है, around the sun. The sun has its own light. We receive light from the sun. However, we see light only in daytime, right? 7 days from Monday to Sunday make 1 week. Okay, 7 days from Monday to Sunday make 1 week. 2 weeks make a fortnight. 4 weeks make a month. Then 12 months make a year. And in this manner, we reckon means we calculating time in bigger and bigger units. 1 year is followed by another, and when 100 years go by, a century is completed. When 10 centuries, that is 1000 years are gone, a millennium is completed. Such a method of dividing time is known as a unilinear division of time. Right? In the unilinear division of time, years that follows one after the other are arranged in serial order. In history books also, a chain of events that follows one after the other is presented in a linear and serial manner. For this, usually we refer to the Common Era. Common Era means Christian era. Okay, written in short as CE or AD. AD means Anno Domini, which means in the year of our Lord. Our Lord means Jesus Christ. The calendar we use today is based on the Christian era, now called the Common Era. Okay, this era began in memory of Jesus Christ. The first year of this era is the year when it began. Now, measurement of time and methods of measuring time. To measure time is to measure the length of time. We know the following units of measuring time: second, minute, hour, day, week, fortnight, month, year, century, and millennium. A second is the smallest unit of a second is the smallest of these units. Okay, we generally indicate a particular day by writing the date of that day. There are other methods too. We have seen that Christian era began in memory of Jesus Christ. It is an old, age-old custom to start a new era to commemorate a special event. यानी कोई special event या घटनाएं घटती हैं तो उसको याद में रखने के लिए new era पहले के जमाने में start किया जाता था. The coronation of a great king, जैसे कि कोई राजा का राज्यभिषेक. We know that Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj had started a new era or shaka known as Rajyabhishek shaka in 1674 AD to commemorate his coronation. Coronation yani Rajyabhishek. Chalivahan shak and Vikram Samvats are two eras that are used in India. Right. The calendar we use today is based on the common era or Christian era. And now, therefore, the time in history is divided into two main periods: prehistoric period and historic period. Prehistoric period. Prehistory simply means before history. The prehistoric period is the period for which no written records are available by which to write its history. Prehistoric period yani kya? No written records are available. Theek hai? Prehistory simply means before history. Historic period. The historic period is the period for which written records are available using which we can write history. यानी historic period यानी जिसमें कुछ written records, written यानी लिखे हुए, write, wrote, written. Clear? Write यानी लिखना, W-R-I-T-E, write. Written, written records यानी जो लिखे गए हैं वो. ठीक है? The historic period is the period for which written records are available using which we can write history. Clear? No. Means time in history, prehistoric period, no written records available, and historic period, written records are available. Okay. Now, see the blackboard. See the blackboard. Let us revise some points. Revision, sources of history. Okay. On the blackboard. Important points. History is a coherent account of the past event in the progress of human culture. Oral sources, written sources, material sources are called the sources of history. Oral sources, written sources, material sources are called the sources of history. All these are the three types of or three kinds of sources of history. Then second is the smallest unit to measure the time. Second ka ta, minute ka ta, aise hi kehte hai na hum, wahi second hai ye. Second is the smallest unit to measure the time. Then food, clothes, shelter, education and health are our बेसिक नीड्स. हमारी बेसिक जरूरतें कौन सी है? अन्न, वस्त्र, निवारा, शिक्षा और आरोग्य. देन वी लाइक द कंपेनियनशिप ऑफ अवर फैमिली मेंबर्स, रिलेटिव्स एंड फ्रेंड्स. हमें किसके साथ रहना अच्छा लगता है? वी लाइक द कंपेनियनशिप ऑफ अवर फैमिली मेंबर्स, रिलेटिव्स एंड फ्रेंड्स. ओके, नाउ सी द राइट साइड ऑफ द ब्लैक बोर्ड. 7 days, 1 week. 7 days, 1 week. 2 weeks, 1 fortnight. 4 weeks, make a month. 12 months, make a year. 100 years, a century. And 1,000 years, a millennium completed. ठीक है. Units of measuring time: second, minute, hour, day, week, fortnight, month, year, century and millennium. All these are the units of measuring time. Take a screenshot and revise all these points again and again. Okay. take a screenshot and revise all these points again and again. Is it clear? Fine. Take a screenshot. Screenshot le lo. Let us revise some important terms. Let us revise some important terms. Our first term is archaeology. Archaeology means archaeology studies the past. Archaeology studies past cultures with the help of ancient remains. Archaeology studies the past cultures with the help of ancient remains. Then archaeological excavation is the method of digging the ground in order to bring to light any ancient remains that is buried. And archaeologist means archaeologists are the researchers who locate, dig out and study ancient remains. Is it clear? Okay, fine. Now, and the method of digging the ground in order to bring to light any ancient remains that lie buried there is called archaeological excavation. While studying the ancient remains, archaeologists try to find answers to many questions like, to which period do the remains belong? Remains yani avshesh relics. To which civilization do the remains belong? And what was the daily life of the people of that civilization like? What kind of relations did those people have with people of other civilizations? And in what ways did they make use of the natural resources in their surroundings in order to meet their own needs? Okay. Fine. Now, history, complete the concept chart. History of a district, of a village, of human civilization, history of world, history of my own, history of a school, history of state, or history of a nation. Right? Fine. Now, here we stop today. This is our region of lesson of sources of history and time. All these portions related to your unit test. Okay. Now period is over. Bye bye. Take care and learn it by heart.